Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. We are talking about proxy models. Proxy models are really, really great. Some of my coworkers even wrote a song about that. If you ever meet in real life, I'll sing it for you. How about that for a promise? We saw the Q-identity proxy model in the previous video. This video, we're going to see the most common proxy model in your code likely. It's the QSortFilterProxyModel. It's the most common one because it both supports sorting and filtering. And it's kind of ironic, right? I'm telling you about these proxy models that will help you have one responsibility and only one in your class. And then we have one that does both sorting and filtering. But I guess the implementation are really, really close for those two. I'll show you. You can either use them just out of the box. You can take, notice the lack of abstract in the word. So you can take it out of the box. There is not a Q abstract sort proxy filter, whatever model. It's a Q sort filter proxy model. You can take it out of the box and use it. I'll show you how to do that. Or you can subclass it and modify it slightly to be even more useful in certain situations. Let's see both of those. If you just want to take it out of the box and use it, then you're going to use one of these three methods here for sorting and one of these two methods here for filtering. So sorting, you need to specify the role that you want to sort on. Do I want to sort by the length of the videos? Do I want to sort by the name? What do I want to sort on? If you have multiple columns, we have only seen list views with one column. But if you had a table or a tree, then you could specify which column am I sorting on. And of course, the sorting order. Am I sorting ascending or descending? And if I want to filter, I can specify what role am I filtering on again. And then I can filter either a fixed string or a regular expression. And again, it's only a string that I filter on. So if I want to filter, as in our example, we filter an enum, I would need to go down and use one of these two. Now, one of these three methods is to be overloaded. Less than, that is when I sort, then I can specify exactly how I want to sort based on two model indexes. So basically, I'm given two rows in my underlying data structure, and I need to tell, is the left one smaller or greater than the right one? And then that's how my sorting will be done. And if I want to filter, if I only have a list model, then there's obviously not going to be any filtering on the columns, but I can filter on the rows. And basically what I am asked is, given row number I, should that one be included in the result of my work as a proxy model, yes or no? And again, you can do a lot of stuff with exactly that one. Here's again an example from our training material. A proxy model the students are asked to implement, but let me just show you the solution to this one. Let me just run it so you can see. Over here, we have our original model. Now here in this one, the model has been filtered, meaning throw away everything that isn't a video. And over here, it's been sorted. So what we had there was now sorted by the length of the videos. And I have a checkbox down here where I can say, yes, I do not want you to do your job. So now you can see that my filtering model didn't do anything. And of course, my sorting that is based on the output of the filter also will now show the musics and not just the videos. The way that it works is I got my playlist model. We saw that before. That's my input, that's my model at the lowest level. Then I got a video filtering proxy model. That is the one that either includes or excludes videos. And my video filtering proxy model is given the model, my playlist model here as its input. Then I got a duration sort proxy model. That's the sorting model. And it is given the filter proxy model here as its input. And then at the end, I am exporting all of these three as CPP model, CPP filter proxy model, and CPP sort proxy model to the QML level. Let's look at each of these two models in turn. So my video filter proxy model, man, this is a difficult. My video filter proxy model is subclassing from QSortFilterProxyModel, and it has one property, and that property is called video filter enabled, and that's because I can enable or disable remember checkbox from the QML level. My video filter proxy model, basically, this is the method of interest, filter accept rows. So let's see the filter accept row. So the other methods here is just for making that property work. So video filter enabled, that just returns that variable. Set video filter enable is updating the instance variable, emitting the video filter enable changed signal, and is calling. Yeah, that's actually a rather important line. It's calling invalidate filter. And what invalidate filter says is that, yes, I as a proxy model need to go and read all of my data underneath me once again and filter each of them. My filter accept rows look like this. And again, Jesper, I'm sorry, could you go away? Thank you. In here, if I am not supposed to do anything, just return true. And then whatever it gives me, I'll say, yeah, that should be included. So nothing is going to be thrown away. Otherwise, I will go and ask my source model. So I say source model, which is the model that was underneath me. I ask it for an index. So that's a QModel index. That's the special API that is somewhat incomprehensible if you only work with this as a QML developer. This is where the widget world really shows through. But just accept that the code looks like this. Source model index source row, that's what I have over here, zero, and so that's column zero and source parent. So basically what I say is, I would like an index in my source model for this, because the index has a method called data. And I will ask my index for the data of this particular row, namely the media type row. So I need to decide, should videos be included or not, or is it audio? Yeah, should audio be included or not? Well, should the next element be included or not? And only if it's a video, it should be. So what I do is I ask my model underneath, can you please give me an index for this? So I got an index for that number, and now, or for that row underneath. And I go to that model underneath and say, hey, model, can you please tell me the video or the type of this thingy role? And it gives me that back. So the model underneath me now tells me if it's a video or not. And if it's a video, that's when we'll say, okay, if the media type is equal to video, then, well, return that. So videos will be included and audio will not. We didn't even look at the QML in the previous example, but let's just do that here. It is straightforward. I got a row here with three list views. One of them is connected to CPP model, the other to CPP filter proxy model, and the last one to CPP sort. CPP sort proxy model. And then the checkbox here that updates the property of whether it should be enable filtering of videos or not. That's basically everything I wanted to tell you about proxy models. They are really useful to structure your application. Let me give you one word of warning though. So especially when you use the QSort filter proxy model, it goes like this. Hey, dear proxy, how many elements do you have? And you have been working with model view now, and we talked about those satellites and whatnot, and all we needed to know is how many satellites are there. So we just look in a database for how many satellites there is, and we can say there is 200 satellites. But imagine that our data was really hard to get to. And we only, let's imagine also, we only wanted to include the red satellites. Now, how many rows do you have This is a filter, right? QSort filter proxy model. How many rows do you have? And you would expect that that would be an easy one to return. But the QSort filter proxy model would now need to do the following. Hey, dear database underneath me, can you please give me how many rows you have? I'm glad you ask. I have 200 rows. Excellent, 200 rows. No, I can't tell my view how many rows I have. Can you please give me the color of the satellite on row number 0, blue? Okay, blue is not equal to red, so 0. Can you give me on row number 2, red? Okay, I'm up to 1. Row number 3, red, 2. Row number 4, cyan, so still not red. Row number 200. That is 1 hour later, because for every single satellite I need to ask for the color, I need to go up to the satellite and, well, I need to call my friend at ISS that will look out of the window to determine the color. I'm just making it up. Yes, I know. But you get the idea. I need to go and fetch all the data from that model underneath. Very, very expensive, possibly. And I challenge you another thing. I'll not do this for you. I'll let you do that. Please do and add a print hello world in your data method and just bring up a simple model and just move the cursor a bit around. You will notice that the view is even more annoyingly stupid than I am. It will ask again and again and again and again about the same thing. So the view will ask the model a lot of things. So you better be careful with your implementation. Make sure that they are performant, and if they can, do add some caching down there. That was it for proxy model. I will end this module here by showing you how you can look at the proxy models in Gamma Ray. But that's in the next video. You still have time to subscribe to our channel, and until then, have a great day.